Here's how I sell a Klein bottle. Somebody goes to my website, buys a bottle, comes down into my office. I print out a receipt and a packing slip. Okay, let's send it out. This has nothing to do with mathematics, everything with running a home business. Whoever buys a Klein bottle from me, I figure I'm going to meet them. They're going to bump into me. And so I'm going to make sure that when they see me, I hope they'll be my friend. Okay, somebody's ordered a Klein bottle. Ask my robot. The robot delivers a box of bottles. I bring it over here. I go weigh it. Step one, take a picture of it. All these mathematicians are smiling at it. Weather permitting, I'm going to walk outside. Take a picture of the guy against the sky. Against whatever is blossoming, whatever leaves there are. How about, hey, okay, come on in. Just spent all of, what, a minute walking through the garden? And, oh, wait a second. Ah, check this out. Fall color is here. Again, why am I going to do this? Has nothing to do with mathematics. It's because if somebody buys a Klein bottle, I celebrate by walking through our little backyard garden. Come on back in. Let's wrap this up. Well, bubble wrap, not yet out the door, but hey, here's what's coming. Almost getting there. But first, before we pack everything up, throw in some sheets of unimportant information. A calibration decal runs from 0.0 milliliters all the way up to 0.00 to 0.0000 milliliters. Start some bubbles. Come on, Mr. Machine. It's a bottle. It's a glass bottle that I hope means fragile. Mr. Fragile, or maybe Miss Fragile, or Mrs. Fragile, or fragile them. Fragile? The pictures, they're for two purposes. Purpose one is to fix my mistakes. If I forgot something, if I screwed up, it shows up in the camera. The other thing, therefore, is to send to my customer.
I see you've put lots of automation in place in various ways, but it still seems like a really time-intensive purpose with all the handwritten messages and the drawings.
Brady, it's time-intensive. It's a labor of love. I can't say I make the glass bottles myself. At my age, I'm tired of burning my fingers. And they didn't do that much anyway. But everything else, packing them, making sure that it's going to the right person, making sure that it's not going to break along the way.
How often do they break?
How often do my Klein bottles break?
In the post.
In the post. About one in 200, one in 300 is broken on delivery. I mean, of course, you know, if I take it like this, my floor is cushioned, so I'm not worried about it breaking on my floor. But I'm also not worried about, when I first started putting these in boxes, I chose the box and I chose the method of cushioning them by going to a step ladder and standing 5 feet about a meter and three quarters off of concrete, on top of concrete, dropping them from a ladder first on that end, then throwing it up like this, and letting it drop a lot of times. You know, over and over again. Well, and here, this is a cushiony floor, but I did it over concrete. Needless to say, I also guarantee these Klein bottles, you know, if it arrives broken, if it arrives broken, I'll replace it immediately. In fact, one thing I say is, look, I want you to be happy. I want my customer to be smiling. So if it breaks in the first 3 months, send me a picture of the broken thing. Send me $10. I'll replace it. Is my little forklift robot to go pick Klein bottles from stock. Tilt the thing. If you look carefully at it, let's see if I can actually show this. I mean, this is just homebrew. This is only incidental. This is not Klein bottles. This is how to run a warehouse, really.